Hi everyone, welcome to another video. Today's topic is power-ups in ZWIFT, what they're all about, how to use them, how do you get them, benefits, that type of stuff. I think we should jump into ZWIFT and see what they're all about. Let's go.
Hey folks, welcome to ZWIFT. As I said in the intro, today we're going to look at power-ups, the different types of power-ups you can get and what they're useful for. Today we're on London. We're going to ride the Greater London Loop. So that's got the extended sort of flat section, but then also includes Box Hill. So you see the top left little circle next to the blue watt box. That's where your power-ups are collected. You collect a power-up every time you pass a start-finish banner, a sprint banner, the top of a KOM. So any overhead banner that you pass through, provided you're not already holding a power-up, you can collect a new one. Power-ups are a really useful addition to the game. There's a lot of mixed views, especially when it comes to racing. Should you have them, should you not? At the end of the day, ZWIFT, and I think I've said this in a few vlogs before, ZWIFT have gamified training. Some organisers will allow you to use power-ups, some organisers won't. Most recently, if you've watched my CVR vlog, I'll stick a wee link up there. Get my opinion on races that don't use power-ups. I like that type of racing, but I also like power-ups because they do add an extra element into the race. What's the power-ups that we've got? The one you can see just now, a little green feather. Basically, that's the lightweight. If you are going to be doing a climb, you hit that power-up, so you can either use the ZWIFT mobile link, or if you're using the keyboard, you can use spacebar. So the feather power-up, perfect for climbing. It's going to reduce your weight, so therefore an increase momentarily of your watts per kilo. So effectively you can climb faster with the same amount of effort for that little short duration. So if you're in the ZWIFT mobile link, initially you'll go into game and your main screen is probably map. Shows you a little overhead view of where you are, riders around you. You've got your metrics. So 145, 143 watts, 75 RPM, 116 beats per minute, and my speed, etc. So the same as what you see on screen. Down the bottom, your on stop button, your U-turn button, which you need to press and hold. You've got your elbow flick, your little wave, the whatever. So up the top, if you select dashboard, and that's the old metrics view. So up the top, you've got a big wattage figure, then your speed, how many meters you've climbed, etc, etc. Down the bottom, if you've got a power up, you'll have a green bar. So for me at the moment, I've got a green bar and it says featherweight. So if I click on that bar, that'll activate the power up. And when your power up's activated, you'll see around the green circle, there's a little semi-transparent border. When you activate it, that border will change to an opaque color and then we'll slowly count down, flash at the end, that's your power up done. So we've got a little gradient coming up here, top right, 5%, putting out 200 watts. So at the moment, roughly, 3 watts per kilo, riding at 19k. So 5% now. So let's hit that, see what it does. We'll try and stay consistent. So there we go, opaque banner's going down. And you can see my watts is jumped. Sorry, my watts per kilo has jumped. 3.5, 3.7. I've only put out an extra couple of watts. And there we go, drops back down to 3. And I'm up to 20k per hour. So we need to wait until we cross another banner, pick up another power-up. The power-ups are completely random. So we'll skip forward in the video until we've got the next power-up. So today's ride, trying to keep it in between 160 and 180. It's a zone 2, so endurance. So as we talked about last week, it's really important to get as many zone 2 miles in as you can. It builds a good aerobic base. Because the thing with zone 2, although I said it's really important if you want to be specific to work to power, the thing with zone 2 is it's not a proper zone 2 unless you're also looking at your heart rate. 55 to 75% of your FTP, so So your functional threshold power will put you into zone 2 power, but to get the best out of it, you need to try and maintain under 85% of your maximum heart rate. And that way, you know you're working your aerobic capacity. The body is delivering enough oxygen through the blood to the muscles. That oxygen's carrying nutrients. The muscles are then doing a little bit of chemistry magic, getting some fuel, keeping you going. And then any waste products, the muscles, the blood is then transporting back. So really important to try and keep your heart rate down whilst maintaining those power figures. Although it might seem that zone 2 isn't really of any benefit. So although you think, do you know what, I'm a racer, I need high tempo, I need to extend my threshold. That's true, you do need to do that. But you're not going to be able to do that if the body can't cope with transporting oxygen around the body. Because the thing with higher power intensities is the duration at which you can maintain those is far less than endurance. So you need to make sure that you're doing as much work as possible across all of the zones and getting a good balanced workout. Now, as I said in I think last week's video maybe, I know I've not been doing enough endurance work recently. I've been working on other things. Coming up to Christmas, there's not been as much time on the bike as I wanted, and the time that I have had, I've spent racing, which is fine at certain times in the year. But at the moment, if I want to plan ahead for the outdoor season, then I need to be working now and building that base. You hear people talking about base all the time. That's exactly what you are. You're building your base, your foundation, on which you can do longer miles, harder efforts, faster recoveries. It all starts with zone 2. But in the absence of a new power-up, let's talk about them. So, you've got featherweight, reduces your weight for climbing. You've got the aero helmet, which reduces your drag. So therefore, on the flats, on the downhill, it's going to make you faster. You've got the truck, which benefits you when you're in the draft. So you need to put out less power to maintain the wheel of the rider in front. And then you've got two XP bonuses. You've got a small plus and a big plus. As the number of riders hitting level 25 increases, those power-ups obviously become non-applicable. But of course, there's new riders coming into Zwift all the time. And of course, this is who this video is based at, the new riders. And with the exception of the XP bonuses, which you just apply points to your account straight away, all power-ups last for about 30 seconds. That's what they are, how to use them. Technically, right now, I could use a truck, because although I'm climbing, I am in the draft of a rider in front. Although the truck is not going to benefit me as much as a feather would, because on this 7% gradient, reduction in weight would serve me much better than a reduction in my drag. And likewise, an aero power-up is not really going to do anything on a climb. You want to keep that for a descent, because you will go so much faster if you want to try and attack over the top of a hill, or obviously on the flat. Very useful if you're in a group or a race. Two benefits: you can either try and push yourself off the front, or if you've dropped off the back, you want to try and catch up the gap, an aero power-up would be ideal. Similarly, the truck, I see this all the time, people using the truck when they're at the front of a group, serves no benefit to you whatsoever if you're not in the draft. So to be fair, for racing, the truck is probably the least useful. Okay, so coming up on the banner, let's see if we pick anything up. So we picked up the truck. So what we need to do, get onto a flat section, get into the draft, hopefully somebody going round about the same pace as us, which on a free ride is sometimes difficult to find. And then we'll activate the blue draft boost and we'll show you what it does. Going back to the aero helmet, one thing we didn't mention, so it's good for taking a break or making a break. It's good for catching up if you've dropped off. But the other thing, and probably the main thing, sprinting. A lot of racers on Zwift in the last maybe two, sometimes even three laps, because of the randomness of the power-ups, they'll get the aero helmet, they'll hang on to it, because they know the way that Zwift racing goes, 7 or 8 times out of 10, it's going to come down to a sprint. So let's see if we can latch onto these people, show you what the draft boost is all about. Okay, so chap in front doing 1.2, try and slow down to his pace. Okay, so he's doing 1.6, we're currently doing 1.1, we're staying in the draft, we hit the draft boost. He's up to 2.3, 1.9 for us. We're still staying with him. We're still in the draft. Obviously we've hit a little climb, so he's accelerating ever so slightly. But the effort we need to put out to hang on to that wheel is a lot less. And there we go. We're jumping back up to 2.2. And what you can do is you can use this, let 5 minutes pass, turn around, go back the other way through the banner, pick up another one, and play a little bit of power-up roulette. You may or may not pick up what you want. Quite often you'll find racers will do that. Well, the best way, if you leave yourself enough time, log in, right through the banner, pick up a power-up, no good, exit out of the game. Go back in, go through the banner, rinse and repeat until you get the power-up you want. Do your warm-up, jump into the racing pen, and off you go, starting with the power-up that you wanted. Here we go, that's our 30k done. Just a minute short of the hour. We'll just finish this off, and then we'll jump back on the computer. We'll just recap the power-ups that we've been talking about today. What they're good for, how'd you get them, how'd you use them. See you in a little bit.
So, there we are, folks. Little bit of ZWIFTing, trying to show you some of the power-ups. Unfortunately, we didn't pick up the aero, but, you know, never mind. So, let's recap. Power-ups. Some races allow them, some races don't. Obviously, you can use them on free rides as well, but they're most beneficial when you're doing a race. Not usable on a TT bike, not usable within workouts. So just free riding and racing, and only on normal bikes. Feather. Reducing your weight by 15 pounds for 15 seconds, so therefore making it far easier to climb with a higher watts per kilo. The truck increases the effectiveness of the draft, and that lasts for 30 seconds. As I said in the video, really beneficial when you're in the draft, not really much good if you're out the front because you're not drafting off anyone. Can be used if you've dropped off the back, a little bit of an effort to just get you close, hit that boost, and then as you pick up the draft at the 5 meter point, then you should be able to cruise back into the peloton. The aero helmet, so the one that we didn't see today, great for sprinting, great for attacking off the front, great for trying to catch up if you've fallen off the back. Also good if you want to sprint to the finish or attacking up and over a climb and then down the other side. It's going to reduce your CDA by 25%, and again, like the truck, it'll last for 30 seconds. The small bonus, the big bonus, we obviously didn't see them. For me, as a level 25 rider, doesn't make any difference. The small bonus, or the small little plus, that's going to give you 10 bonus points. It's about the same as half a kilometer. The big plus is going to give you 250 points, which is about 12 and a half kilometers ridden. So, I hope you find that really useful. Drop me a thumbs up if you've liked today's video. Smash that like button, tickle it, hit it. Whatever you do, just touch that button. Subscribe to the channel if you're not already doing so. Sorry for the cold today, by the way. Share the video, let's spread the love. And as ever, guys, I'll see you again soon for some new videos. Ride on.